dressed in their beautiful costumes, inspired by Charles Dickens from Walt Disney World. Ladies and gentlemen, the voices of liberty.
Thank you.
Major Alan Bonner, who will start us off with the Air Force Band, Joy to the World. If you want to sing, do. We have a medley of old favorites. Thank you, sir. Last one in our medley, and we want everybody to get in the spirit, get the mood set, get the tree lights all shaken up so we can sing a little bit of Jingle Bells. What would it be like without Jingle Bells? The sleigh is all set, the reindeer on order, and okay, if we can, please, Major, add a one and a two and a three. Let's go. Let's have a big round of applause for Mickey, for Minnie, for the entire gang. And now, while we're all hot... Thank you.
Santa, your master of ceremonies for the 1985 Christmas Pageant of Peace pre-lighting ceremony, Willard Scott, escorted by those famous Goodwill ambassadors from Walt Disney World, Mickey Mouse and Minnie Mouse.
And right now, ladies and gentlemen, if you will please, welcome with me from Galesburg, one of the great towns in all America. Ladies and gentlemen, the music you're about to hear is the beginning of the Christmas season. Six consecutive years, which means either one of two things. They can't get anybody else, or he's doing a dynamite job. Would you welcome back one of my favorite people in the whole world, Mr. Joseph H. Riley.
Thank you very much, Santa. On behalf of all of us who bring you this annual pageant, boy made good, Mr. Willard Scott. For 25 years, the General Electric Company of Cleveland, Ohio, through Mr. Frank Lagaza, has designed and provided the lighting for our national tree, as well as the state trees we have here surrounding the main tree. We are grateful for GE's generosity and most appreciative to be the beneficiary of individual trees. The Washington Convention and Visitors Association and the National Park Service National Capital Region, which gives year-round care to this national Christmas tree and our beautiful park. They also provide help and coordination during the 3 weeks the trees are lighted. Thanks also to the many groups who provide evening programs for the pleasure of our visitors who come to Washington, and they are many, because last year we had 900,000 persons that visited this site for the annual spectacle. A very special thank you to the Westport Marketing Group of Westport, Connecticut, their chairman Richard Rovsek and Peggy Hinkle. For the fifth year, they have provided production and coordination of many elements of the pageant. Each year, a theme is chosen for the pageant, and this year our theme is traditions. By comparison to many countries, ours is a young nation. Our traditions, therefore, may not be as deep-rooted, but like the tree that we light this evening, they have enjoyed a steady growth. The tradition of Christmas, regardless of religious belief, spotlights to the world the image of the United States. The very foundation, thank you all for being with us this evening, and to continue our program, the world's greatest Santa, Mr. Willard Scott.
Thank you, Josie.
Okay,
Fantastic. Joe's asked me to announce that copies of his speech are available. Just send $2,000 to Joseph Riley in care of any fixed address. This is one of the great thrills for me to come home because I consider this my hometown number one. Old Santa Claus, you know, comes from Washington, D.C. Anybody that's ever tried to hit the federal treasury up knows that. But to be back here to light the national Christmas tree and be a part of this, especially on this night when I'm grateful, because just today, old Santa, you know, works for RCA. And it was just announced today that...
That sounds good. Let's put some words to that.
Do you love a Christmas tree?
Yes, we love a Christmas tree.
And isn't all the candy free?
Oh, yes, all the candy's free. Candy free.
Christmas tree. Christmas tree. What a merry Christmas.
Christmas tree.
Voices of Liberty. Would you like to hear him do one more? Do you like that? There's more where that came from. Encore time.
Hark, 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 bells, sweet silver bells, all seem to say, throw cares away, Christmas is here, bringing good cheer to young and old, meek and the bold, ding, 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 dong, that is the song, ring, chime, or ring, dong, caroling.
One seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere, filling the air, oh, how they pound, raising the sound, hurling, ding, hurling, the cheer, getting in the ring, while people...
Thank you all so much. That was beautiful. From Disney World, the Voices of Liberty, and a medley of old favorites. Now, at this point of the program, it is always traditional and appropriate to have a Christmas prayer. And this year, I'm pleased to... Now, that is really solemn. It's nice to have a legend here tonight to perform for you. This man is truly a legend in show business, and as a matter of fact, he's had so many hit records and so many hit albums. Now, ladies and gentlemen, someone you're going to lose your heart to here and now for the Pageant of Peace, our own special Christmas present, Mr. Tony Bennett.
Yes, please. Thank you, Maestro. This is Bing Crosby's song. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. Of a white Christmas, with every Christmas card I write, may your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white. Well, it's such a pleasure for me to sing with this magnificent Air Force Orchestra. And right now, here's a song that was made very famous by the wonderful Nat King Cole. A song written by Mel Torme. chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child will want to spy to see if reindeers really know how to fly. So I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. Oh, you're beautiful. Thank you for being so lovely. Thank you. I'd love to have you meet my daughters, Antonia and Joanna. It's Joanna and Antonia. Hi, Antonia. Sit down. Okay. You all right? Okay. Yes. Yeah. The kids in boy and girl land will have a jubilee. They're gonna build a toyland town all around that Christmas tree. Oh, you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not fight. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Here he comes to town. We're going to do some wonderful spiritual Christmas songs for you now with the wonderful Carl Sandburg Choir. Okay, whenever you're ready, it's fine. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Oh, come let us adore.
Thank you very much.
Carlsberg Choir from good old Galesburg, Illinois. Hip, hip, hooray. And Alan Bonner and the Air Force Band, who could ask for more? Well, I see by the old clock on the wall that Santa Claus 1 and Mrs. Claus are standing by. And a brilliant introduction, my good friend Joseph Riley, the president of the Pageant of Peace. Bring on little Joe.
Got it. Thank you, Willard. Isn't he great? And thank you, too, Mr. Bennett. Your appearance here tonight has been a highlight for all of us. Mr. Bennett will be back after the tree lighting with a special number for those here present. Now, if you will direct your attention to the large screen to your left, I have the honor to present to you, live from the White House, the President of the United States and Mrs. Reagan.
Thank you, Joe Riley. My fellow Americans, thank you for joining Nancy and me on this festive evening. The menorah stands lighted in Lafayette Park, for this is also the time of Hanukkah, and this season is rich in the meaning of our Judeo-Christian tradition. In a moment, we'll be lighting the national Christmas tree, carrying forward what is now a 62-year tradition first begun by Calvin Coolidge. Tonight, we're drawn in warmth to one another as we reflect upon the deeply holy meaning of the miracle we shall soon celebrate. We know that Mary and Joseph reached the stable in Bethlehem sometime after sunset. We do not know the exact moment the Christ child was born, only what we would have seen if we'd been standing there as we stand here now. Suddenly, a star from heaven, shining in our eyes, shining with brilliant beauty across the skies. A star pointing toward eternity and the night, like a great ring of pure and endless light. And then, all was calm and all was bright. Such was the beginning of one solitary life that would shake the world as never before or since. When we speak of Jesus, and of his life, we speak of a man revered as a prophet and teacher by people of all religions. And Christians speak of someone greater, a man who was and is divine. We brought forth a power that is infinite and a promise that is eternal, a power greater than all mankind's military might, for his power is godly love, love that can lift our hearts and soothe our sorrows and heal our wounds and drive away our fears. He promised there will never be a long night that does not end. He promised to deliver us from dark torment and tragedy into the warming sunlight of human happiness and beyond that, into paradise. He's never been a halfway giver. His generosity is pure and perfect and sure. This then expresses the true meaning of Christmas. If each of us could give but a fraction to one another of what we gave, to what he gave to the whole human family, how many hearts could heal, how much sorrow and pain could be driven away. There's still time for joy and gladness to touch a sad and lonely soul, still time to feed a hungry child, to wrap a present for a kind old man feeling forlorn and afraid, and to reach out to an abandoned mother raising children on her own. There's still time to remember our armed forces, to express our profound gratitude to those keeping watch on faraway frontiers of freedom, and to redouble our energies to account for our MIAs. They are not and never will be forgotten. And there's still time to remember the deepest truth of all, that there can be no prisons, no walls, no boundaries separating the members of God's family. Let us reach out tonight to every person who is persecuted. Let us embrace and comfort, support and love them. Let us come together as one family, under the fatherhood of God, binding ourselves in a communion of hearts for tonight and tomorrow and for all time. May we give thanks for an America abundantly blessed, for a nation united, free, and at peace. May we carry forward the happiness of the Christmas spirit as the guiding star of our endeavors 365 days a year. And as we light this magnificent tree, may all the youthful hope and joy of America light up the heavens and make the angels sing. Merry Christmas, and God bless you all. And now we're going to light the tree.
Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Here we are, as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends will be dear to us. Gather near to us once more. Through the years we all will be together, if the fates allow. Hang a shining star on the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas now.
Happy holidays.
Mickey and Minnie and our wonderful Santa, Willard Scott. And now, as we leave here this evening, the Air Force Band will entertain with selections, and the brass choir and from the Pringree School will join in. So as you leave tonight, keep the spirit in your hearts, and a very merry, merry Christmas to everyone.